In this tutorial, we will learn how to select and cut out parts of photographs to create a collage. This is the collage we will be creating today using two photographs. So first we are going to start by cutting out elements of this city skyline photo. You can find this photo in the description below. Let's go ahead and create a blank canvas to create our collage. So we are going to make our collage by going to File, New. And we will create a canvas that's 1,000 pixels by 1,000 pixels, 72 dpi. Click Create. Now let's go ahead and save this. So let's navigate back to the photo we want to use for our collage. I'm going to show you today various tools in your toolbar that you can use to make various selection types. Let's start with the Marquee Tools. The marquee tools are located here. If you click and hold, you'll see that several marquee tools appear. We are going to start by using the rectangular marquee tool. Let's practice using the rectangular marquee tool by selecting the sidewalk. So all you have to do is you click, hold, and you drag to make a selection in a rectangle. Once you've made a selection, you will see some moving lines around the selection. If you zoom in, you can see them a little better. I like to call these the marching ants because they kind of move to indicate your selected area. You can also make adjustments to these selections we're making today. So if I wanted to lighten or darken this selection, all I would need to do is open up an adjustment tool like our levels, and you can lighten and darken this sidewalk. So this is the first element we'll add to our collage. Go to the Move tool. Click into our selection and click and drag, and drop this selection into our collage file. It's a little big. I actually want this to be much smaller and on the bottom. So I'm going to use the Transform tool or Command T and just make this sidewalk a little bit smaller in my design. All right, back to our skyline. Now let's say instead of the sidewalk, we wanted to select everything except the sidewalk, so the sky and the skyline. There's an easy way to do that by going to Select, Inverse. And that just moved my selection up to the top. So it selected everything except the sidewalk. You could also make a new adjustment to this layer. I'm going to make a saturation adjustment, make that sky a little bluer. You can also delete these selections pretty easily. You have to have a second layer, so I'm going to just duplicate my layer quickly and turn that background layer off, but you could also just delete a layer in your file. I'm going to click Command Z. So let's deselect our selection. Go to Select, Deselect. You can also do Command D on a Mac to deselect. Let's now go to our Elliptical Marquee Tool. We're going to grab a circle out of the sky and put it in our collage. With the elliptical marquee selected, click into your bluest part of the sky. Hold down Shift, starting at the top left, click and drag to create a perfect circle. And now with your Move tool selected, click into your shape, click and hold and drag this to your tab with the collage and drop it. Going to resize. Going back to my skyline photo, let's deselect this circle. Select, deselect. All right, let's go down the list to our next selection tool. It's called the Lasso tool. With this tool, we are going to select this skyscraper building and put it in our collage. So let's zoom in. You can use your zoom tool or you can go Command plus plus plus. There are three lasso tools. I'll show you two of them, the lasso and the polygon. Let's start with the lasso. This tool makes a very freehand selection. So you can quickly just draw a circle around what you want to select, and you want to close your selection. So make sure you go back to the place where you started and then release. So you're clicking and holding the whole time. Let's deselect this and try the other lasso tool. Let's go back over here and select the Polygon Lasso tool. This is my favorite selection tool. I use it all the time. It allows you to select straight edges in a photograph much easier. So with the Polygon Lasso tool selected, I want you to click around this building, and all you do is just click, click, click. And you can zoom in as you're clicking, so you can get very detailed with this if you'd like. Okay, and I finished my selection. I ended where I started, so I closed the selection. And now you can see my marching ants around the selection. So let's say I actually wanted to add this little building down here. So with the Polygon Lasso tool selected, you can see my cursor has a little plus sign next to it. This means I can add to my selection. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to now trace or add to my selection by clicking around this little building here. And again, you have to close your selection. It now added to my selection. But let's now take it away again. So if I want to subtract it, you hold down the Option key on a Mac, you get a minus sign now. So if you click and hold that minus sign, now we can click around this building again to remove it from the selection. You gotta close that selection. Now let's add this to our collage. Select the Move tool, click and hold and drag it up to our collage tab and drop it. And let's transform it, make it a little bit smaller. And I actually want the sidewalk to be in front of my building. So I'm going to move this sidewalk layer on top. Now let's deselect this building. We're going to add a little section of the skyline to the bottom of our collage. So I'm going to focus in on the left-hand side of this photograph. So the next tool down, you have a couple tools that I use very often, the Magic Wand tool and the Quick Selection tool. Let me quickly show you the Magic Wand tool. This works great on solid colors. So what it does, if you click into your photograph, it's going to select everything that's a similar color. You can easily add to your selection by hitting the Shift key and the Option key on a Mac to get that plus. You can also subtract. Okay, I'm going to go select, deselect. We're going to try the Quick Selection tool here. I'm going to zoom in a little further. And how this works is you just click and drag across something you want to select with your cursor. I'm going to make my cursor a little bit bigger. You can see it here. It's kind of small. I'm going to bump it up, bump up the size. So I'm just going to start clicking and holding and dragging across my skyline. And you can see it's starting to select things that it thinks I am trying to select. I keep clicking and dragging across my skyline. And you can see it's doing an okay job. It's not perfect. We are going to clean it up here in a second, though. So I'm just going to keep adding to my selection. So that did an okay job. I can see a couple issues though. Right around the top of the skyline, there's some pieces that are missing. And then down here, it's selected part of this concrete step. I don't actually want that at all. So at this point, you can zoom in and then maybe make your little brush a little smaller. And you can get a little more detailed with this brush and zoom closer in. So you can go along the top here, add, or you can also subtract by holding down the Option key. You can see that is now a negative sign in the middle. I'm going to go down here to my step and use the negative sign to try to just delete that concrete step that I don't want. You can also mix and match these selection tools a little bit. So if I was wanting to get very detailed with this, I would also use my Polygon Lasso tool to really hone in on my selections. So by switching to that tool, you could zoom way into your skyline and fix these little details. Remember, you have to close your selection each time. Last step, let's use our move tool. Let's take this selection we created and let's move it into our collage. And we want to drop this on top, so on front of the sidewalk. I'm going to reduce the size of this just a hair. Okay, and the very last step is I want to add a nice background where the white is right now. I'm gonna open a file with a sunset in it. I'm going to click and drag the sunset into the back of my collage. So that's how you select and cut out parts of photographs to create a collage. Subscribe to Cry Studio for more Photoshop tutorials. Thanks so much.